Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in this video we will derive the general balance equation for the alternating current bridge network. So let us start with our topic. The alternating current bridges or AC bridges are the most popular and accurate instruments which are used for the measurement of AC resistance, capacitance and impedance. Also, they can be used for the measurement of storage factor and power factor. Now, these alternating current bridges, they are based on the Wheatstone bridge. Just like the Wheatstone bridge, it consists of four arms, and in these four arms, it will have four impedances. In Wheatstone bridge, we were having four resistances. P and Q were the ratio arms, and these are the known resistances, and R is the unknown resistance, and S is the standard resistance. Now, in case of alternating current bridges, we will have four impedances. Impedances are a combination of the resistance, inductance and the capacitance. So we were having four impedances. In place of galvanometer, we will have a detector, and this detector is used for balancing the bridge. And in case of the Wheatstone bridge, we were having a battery which is providing the EMF to the bridge network or power supply to the bridge network. In case of alternating current bridges, we will have an AC voltage source which will provide the power supply to the bridge network. So if we draw a basic AC bridge network, it will consist of four arms. So this is an alternating current bridge in which we are having the four arms AB, BC, CD and DA. And in these four arms, we were having four impedances Z1, Z2, Z3 and Z4. Okay. Here we are having a detector which is connected between the arm B and D, and between the arm A and C we are having the alternating voltage source. Now this voltage source, suppose it is providing the EMF E, and I is the current flowing in this. So I1 is the current flowing in the first arm, I2 is the current flowing in the second arm, I3 is the current flowing in this third arm, and I4 is the current flowing in the fourth arm. E1 is the voltage drop in this first arm, E2 is the voltage drop across this BC arm, E3 is the voltage drop across DA branch, and CD we are having E4 as the voltage drop. So this is the complete basic alternating current bridge network. Now let us derive the balance equation for this bridge. We know that in the Wheatstone bridge, the bridge is said to be balanced when the galvanometer shows null deflection. Means the no current is passing through the galvanometer. No current is passing means the potential difference between the points B and D, it is zero. means the points B and D, they are at the same potential. So here also this alternating current bridge is said to be balanced when the detector, it shows null deflection. Okay, no deflection means the detector, it is having like a constant or a frequency of a constant magnitude is heard here. So B and D will be at the same potential. That means the voltage drop E1 is equal to the voltage drop E3. So we can say that the bridge is balanced when the bridge is balanced. We will have potential of point B is equal to potential of point D. Okay, that means the voltage drop in arm AB is equal to the voltage drop across BA, across arm DA. Okay, so here we will have E1 will be equals to E3. Now if we write the value of E1, E1 is the voltage drop across this impedance Z1, I1 is the current flowing through it. So the value of E1 will be I1 Z1, value of E3 will be I3 Z3. So let's put the value in it. E1 is what? I1 Z1 and this is I3 Z3. So this is the equation which we have obtained. Now also, when the bridge is balanced and the B and D points, they are at the same potential, it means no current is flowing through this detector. So all the current I1, it will be equal to the current I2, because no current is flowing in this arm. So I1 will be equals to I2. Similarly, I3 will be equals to I4. No current is flowing in this arm. So another equation we have got is I1 will be equals to I2 and I3 will be equals to I4. Now if we write the value of I1, we know that I1 will be equal to the potential divided by the equivalent resistance. Now I1 is the current across this. Okay, so the total EMF is E divided by the total resistance is Z1 plus Z2. So I1 will be equal to E divided by Z1 plus Z2. Similarly, I3 and I4, they will be equal to total EMF is again E divided by Z3 plus Z4. Because when the bridge is balanced, no current is flowing through this arm, so it can be treated as an open circuit. So when it is open circuit, Z3 and Z4, they will come in series with each other. So it will be equal to E divided by Z3 plus Z4. So these are the second equation which we have got. Now putting the value of this current I1 from the second equation into the first equation and also the value of I3 in this first equation. So what we will get? I1 is what? E upon Z1 plus Z2. So it will be E upon Z1 plus Z2 multiplied with Z1. Equals to E upon Z3 plus Z4 multiplied with Z3. So we have put the value of the current I1 and I3 in these equations. Let's simplify it. E and E will be cancelled. We will get Z1 multiplied with this Z3 plus Z4. And here we will have Z3 multiplied with Z1 plus Z2. Multiply Z1 inside, Z1 Z3 plus Z1 Z4 equals to Z3 Z1 plus Z2 Z3. So Z1, Z3, it will be cancelled on both the sides. So we will get Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3. So this is the general balance equation for an alternating current bridge. This equation says that the multiplication of the impedances in the opposite arms, it is equal to the multiplication of the impedances in the other arm. Okay, or we can say that Z1 upon Z2 equals to Z3 upon Z4. So here Z1, Z4, they are multiplied equals to Z2, Z3. So the impedances which are in the opposite pair of the arms, they will be multiplied. Their multiplication will be equal to the multiplication of the impedances which are present in the opposite pair of the arms. So this is the general balance equation. For an alternating current bridge network. Now here Z1, Z2, Z3 and Z4, these are the complex impedances, means it is a combination of resistance, conductance, resistance, capacitance and the inductance. Now if we are expressing this in the form of admittance, if we want to express this equation in the form of admittance, so we know that admittance Y is the reciprocal of impedance Z. So here we are having the equation Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3. If we replace it in the form of admittance, it will be like 1 by Y1 into 1 upon Y4 is equals to 1 by Y2 into 1 by Y3. So again we will get the same equation Y1, Y4 is equals to Y2, Y3. So this is the balance equation when the we are having the admittance. Okay. Now in polar form the impedance it is represented as. Now we are considering the different forms of the balance equation. So if we express the impedance in polar form, it is expressed as Z equals to Z and angle theta, where Z is the magnitude of the impedance and theta is the phase angle. So we are having the impedances Z1, Z2, Z3 and Z4. So Z1 will now become Z1 theta 1, Z2 theta 2, Z3 will become Z3 theta 3 and Z4 will become Z4 theta 4. We are representing all the impedances in their polar form. So our balance equation was Z1, Z4 equals to Z2, Z3. Replacing it in the form of polar form, so it will become Z1 theta 1, Z4 theta 4, Z2 theta 2 and Z3 theta 3. So what it will be? Z1, Z4, they will be multiplied because they are the magnitudes and phase angle, they will be added. So through this equation, what we are getting, we got two relationships. One relationship is between the magnitude and one relationship is between the phase angle. The magnitude relationship says that the multiplication or the product of the magnitude of the opposite arm of the impedances, it will be equal. And the phase angle relationship says that the sum of the phase angles of the opposite arm of the impedances, they will be equal. So here product of the magnitude is equal. And here sum of the phase angles. So for an AC bridge, alternating current bridge to be balanced, these two equations have to be satisfied. One is the product equation and second is the phase angle equation. Means product of the magnitude of the opposite pair of the impedances, that has to be equal, and sum of the phase angles of the opposite pair of the impedances, it has to be equal. Okay. Now if the impedance it is having an it is an inductive impedance. So for inductive impedance, the ZL, that is the inductance part, it is equal to R plus JXL. Okay. And when we are having a capacitive impedance, ZC is equals to R minus JXC. So in that case, we will replace our impedance in this form. We are going to replace all the impedance, like ZL will be R plus JXL. So we will write the magnitude of ZL plus the phase angle. In this case, we will write the magnitude ZC minus the phase angle. Phase angle will be negative because in the case of capacitance, the voltage and the current, we will have a lag relationship, and here the we are having the lead relationship between the current and the voltage. So XL is represented as 2 pi f L ohms, and XC is represented as 1 upon 2 pi f C ohms. So when the impedances in the alternating current bridges, they are inductive impedance and the capacitive impedance, we will consider, in the case of inductive, we will have a positive phase angle, and in the case of capacitive impedance, we will have a negative phase angle. XL is the capacitive impedance reactance. This is inductive reactance and this is the capacitive reactance. XL is 2 pi FL and XC is 1 upon 2 pi FC. F is the operating frequency, and this is in terms of the unit of measurement is the ohms. So here we studied about the alternating current bridges, how we can find out or derive the balance equation for the alternating current bridges, and the famous equation which we have got is Z1 Z4 is equals to Z2 Z3, that is the product of the impedances of the opposite arms, that is equal. Also we got the relationship between the impedance when they are expressed in the polar forms and when they are expressed in the resistive form, that is in the form of a combination of inductance and a capacitance. Okay. So both polar and the coordinate form of representation of the impedances is considered here. So I hope that this topic, general balance equation for alternating current bridges, is clear to you. Thank you.